My name is Barbara Seibel. I'm a PhD student in comparative literature at the University of Vienna. And together with Professor Ivanovich, who unfortunately couldn't be here today, we are working on a project that crowdsourcing as a starting point for corpus building and the type distinction in comparative literature. We are aiming to construct a prospective typology of translational literature, which is a genre that is not really recognized in literary studies so far. And we are planning to do this by using a classification system that relies on citizen science. Our main objectives are to build a corpus which includes as many relevant texts as possible, and also to elaborate a set of categories to ensure a better understanding of the genre. I will now outline our project and look forward to your input at the end. I also would like to mention that the project is still in its conceptual phase, so we are thankful for any ideas and suggestions. What is translational literature? By definition, translational literature is considered as a way of reflecting on translation in literary texts. But it will be important not to give too many definitions in advance, as we would rather observe which qualities are highlighted by the participants themselves. As a method, we suggest an interactive web portal that entices interested readers to give examples of texts which could be considered as translational and to describe and evaluate them in a similar manner as a lit blog. What are lit blogs? Lit blogs discuss literary texts, and they report personal reader experiences and also rate them. They have been an increasingly important medium of public reflection of literary texts. And some of the main characteristics that are of particular interest for us are that they bring attention to selected titles. They justify the selection but through the impression they make on the reader or blogger. They also provide an argumentative review of books and texts. They create a distinct profile of the readers, and they also foster the creation of the community. There are various different kinds of lit blogs. Here are a few examples. Lonesome Reader on the bottom is a lit blog maintained by a single blogger who provides reviews of books approximately once a week. And he's also in contact with writers, so there's an interaction with writers and readers as well. Then the Rumpus is a lit blog that is more or less like a magazine. Readers can submit reviews and essays on books, and this blog also publishes original fiction as well. And finally, the one on the top left is an interactive blog about La Comédie Humaine by Balzac, and this is a blog similar to what we have in mind, where members they have to register first, and then they can share summaries, reviews, information on a certain topic, in this case about the committee women. And this blog was widely successful. It so far has had about 200,000 views, and even though the project is finished, it still gets a lot of attention, and regular commentaries to the articles are provided. And yes, it was so successful that the blog, that there's two more blogs similar to this now. So lit blogs are increasingly surveyed by publishing houses as well, because they mirror reader behavior, reader consumption behavior, and also help to adjust the business strategies of the publishing houses. So our goal is to motivate bloggers and readers, first of all through an open call to submit reviews of texts they consider as translational, and also to argue why they think they are translational literature. And in addition, other websites such as Goodreads or Yahoo could also prove useful. There is a possibility of reader groups on Yahoo, for example. It's La Comédie Humaine that also works with a Yahoo reader group, which is maintained like a forum where people can exchange their opinions on a topic. The problem, of course, is that these platforms, Goodreads and Reddit as well, are not fully independent. They're owned by Amazon, so that could be maybe a point of critique. And on this portal, we would ask to name and describe texts, and why they should be classified as translational literature, and thus we hope to broaden the selection of texts that will finally be included in the proposed genre description, and also to more precisely define the characteristics of the genre, as well as evaluating the values described to the active translation. So, which value has translation in the public mind? How important is it for readers? In order to prevent abuse, users will be required to register, even directly or via existing social media accounts. And through this registration, we will also gain certain legally permissible data that can later be used in the evaluation of the project. Such data includes native language, country of birth, country of residence, known language education, and so forth. There will be several areas in the interactive portal. For example, where readers can retrieve information and actively participate. There will be rewards for the participants, a rating system, feedback by the supervisor, and also a forum to enhance exchange and a frequency of the contribution. And there will also be a tutorial for the participants, because this has proved successful in similar projects. So what happens with the data? On the index level, we will create a list of texts that have been classified as translational literature. And on the text level, Wiki will be created, providing articles dedicated to the list texts. The articles will be written by the supervisor, so to avoid copyright problems. And the contributors will also be mentioned in a list that will be part of the portal. In a later phase, also the translational text will be implemented in the portal according to copyright regulations. And the data, the metadata on the participants will be collected for statistical evaluation. Of course, the motivational strategies to engage a crowd of contributors will have to undergo constant re-evaluation. Existing social infrastructures might also be useful in order to recruit more participants and also to support knowledge exchange. So we're thinking of social ties and similar platforms. Yes, so we hope by using citizen science to collect texts of translation literature that we will get feedback on the texts we're gathering and also gain new insights about the possibilities of digitally supported literary studies. So the experiment on the one hand hopes to help create a corpus on translation literature and also to define categories. And on the other hand, also to provide experience in digitally supported literary studies, because there are not so many projects so far in this field.